Welcome back, everybody. This is Delassa, and let's go ahead and play another game of Isaac. This time we're going to do a not-quite-so-broken run as Eden. The last one basically proved how crazy the D6 can be. Okay, we're going to start with a Blood of the Mer. Not the worst thing ever, by any means, so our tiers are a bit slow. Not horrible, but a bit slow. We do have a pill. We might as well pop that. What the hell, why not? What the hell, why not? Is generally my option when I can use it. And we have an annoying room. Annoying room is annoying, but at least we got a bomb out of it. I'm going to go ahead and shoot a couple fires here, hopefully it may be a consumable, and it looks like no, that's not going to happen, but we get a penny. Wow, not worth it at all, probably. And yeah, okay, we're on Curse of the Lost, or whichever curse it is that annoyingly tends you to the wrong room. Well, that was bad, but we got two bombs out of it. We probably can find our secret room. Let's go check this other room first. Maybe we'll get lucky and there's a rock next to it. There is not. And I'm going to run in and take dumb damage again. So let's grab that. Is not our secret room. Interesting. I would have thought it was, but as per the norm, I have proven terrible once again in proving where secret rooms are not. Or are, I should say. I'm glorious at proving where they're not. I've almost never failed at that. But we recover a little bit of life, and we will push on. We do have a curse room here, so we'll probably go ahead and check that out, because it's a curse room, and I have generally an almost inescapable desire to go in them. So let's pop in it and see. And it's going to just give us damage and take us back here, so that's annoying. Well, while we're at it, let's go to our actual secret room, which is not there either. Where is it? My lord. Weird. Okay. Okay. We can take infestation. Let's see if it'll actually let us in this time. Double card room. Not bad. That's bad. Like I said, I am more than a shade out of practice of playing Isaac. The last episode I recorded would be the first time I played it in about 3 or 4 months. So, at least we got a hero font to make up for bad things. Okay, we're going to try here. Hell with it. I'm just going to give up at this point. I have no idea what I'm doing, and I should never play this game again, apparently. I should have known that, granted, because looking at the room, you know. That's a magician card, this, because it's going to take a while. Ragman is one of the more annoying first bosses, if you ask me. He's not really that dangerous, just literally has way too much health for a first boss. As well as having annoying spiders that have way too much health as well. Okay, there you're going to get that one back to life. It's going to jump on me like a jerk. And we're going to kill him. And we're going to get at least a decent upgrade of some synth oil. On down we go. And we get a curse of darkness at this point, huh? Oh, lust. Okay. Well, that may be a good one to get us. We may get something that will get us closer to our spun transformation. Or we may just get a stupid pill, so I'm nam 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 nam. And I'm almost positive I did not hit that key, but game does not lie. I hit it and I just didn't realize it. Fat fingers will do that, folks. Let's get that rock at least. Pick up a key and a heart. No sense going in our shop yet. Especially since we have not identified our item room yet, or what was in it. You can just blow up that. That'd be great. And we'll grab the free bomb. And we'll see what's in our item room this time. We have a... What was even? I'll take Tractor Beam. Tractor Beam is not a bad one. It is a good tier speed upgrade, which is kind of what I was lacking, was shot speed a bit. I believe it's also a tier delay upgrade, if I remember right, as well as, you know, the whole Tractor Beam effect. So, not a bad upgrade by any means. We're just going to align all our ducks in a row here, and hopefully they all come down the same funneled area. Or at least close enough that I don't need to worry about them backing around me and hitting me. Blow that up, and we shall proceed. No rocks or anything there, so we'll just go on and have some fun with Mr. Minstrel here. Wow. Not really sure how I dodged that shot. That was kind of a dicey one, to say the least. Sometimes I do amaze myself. Generally on accident, but you know, every once in a while I do something semi-amazing. Alright, we're gonna get a placenta. And our deal with the devil is gonna give us Death Touch again, because why not? And an Abaddon. So we're gonna get all that life back we just lost as Black Hearts, and we're gonna have Death Touch. Okay. We have a great damage of 9. That is crazy damage. So we've got plenty of damage. Endless Nameless, okay. We're gonna get the annoying masks here. And their hearts are gonna be somewhere across the screen, way far from where you start, of course. Grab a key. Onward and upward, as they say. We're on the, in this case, I guess it would be more onward and downward, wouldn't it? Okay. Another husk fight. Kind of been getting a lot of the husk lately. I haven't. We're going to take the Roid Rage, and we'll go see what's in this deal with the devil. We have a Guppy's Collar and a Cambion Conception. Let's take the collar. Why not? It's a Guppy item. And it is useful at times. Okay, let's go find our item room real fast here. We do have a pretty damn good speed now. We're really close to a transformation to into, you know, to spun. We're going to end up with a heart out of here. We're going to have a wrath fight. It's not going to go well for him, I can tell you that right now. Free key. Grab a penny, pick one up, save a buck, something. We'll do it. It's 2 chests, why not? We have more than enough damage and whatnot to make this fairly quickly done. Should be no real issues here getting this done. Yay. I still don't remember what the hell the pill does, and I'm not going to look it up right now. I suppose I don't need the big map up. I'm going to go with the small map. Now that little asshole I am not taking, because I hate this little bastard. One of the worst items in the game as far as I'm concerned. He always ends up getting me killed somehow or another. Generally because he messes with the patterns of the enemies, and I do not do well with that. So, let's just go ahead and head on down. Oh, that was our mini boss, not our big boss. Duh. Well, we might as well go play in this room for a second. You know, we grab a chariot card out of it. Could be worse. 9 pennies is not enough to warrant me bothering with the shop, so let's bomb on down. In the next level! We're going to get our Eternal Heart, of course. We can do our boss room here, which may or may not have been worth it. Wow. Everyone on bosses with too much friggin' health. This would be another one. Yeah, if you could just keep doing that, that'd be great. Those are two bosses that I feel just have too much health. There isn't really any reason for them to have that much health, you know. And you gotta remember, if you look at our damage, we are doing 9 damage per shot. 9. And those guys still took that long to kill, so I call it bad mechanic is bad. Not that and it's more so like the fatties and the cages both, they just have way too much health in my opinion. As I said earlier. That's an interesting room. Not really. When I say interesting, I mean god awful. Luckily we have a good amount of damage and a good shot to take care of it. You can take your spawn and shit somewhere else because nobody around here wants to heal with it. The other good thing about Tractor Beam is the infinite range as well. We're just going to run right through there real fast. Okay, we're going to get a fly. Best bud is a situational at best. But, you know, it's an item, I guess. We're not exactly doing dailies here or anything, so. Besides, I'm terrible at those anyway, so it's fine. Even if we were doing dailies, I'd still be doing badly at them, so it would be fine. And not get anything even remotely close to a good score. Where'd that little bastard go? Oh, there he is. Little sneaky shit. Okay, we're gonna blow this up for the hell of it, take some free damage for the hell of it. Everything's all gonna blow up everywhere, and it's gonna be great. There's a spirit rock, at least. And I'm going to take some more damage because I'm bad at this game. Please repair my life. Okay. Well, let's give it a try and see if it's over here. It is not. Running all the way back to the first one there, which would be the actual non-shop room, is probably not going to be worth it, so we're not going to do it. We're just going to do this, so yeah. Come here, come here, come here. I win. Completely useless mom's underwear. Well, I guess it's not completely useless because it is still could be used in transformation still, so there is that, I guess. Krampus is going to do what he does best and be a dick. See? Told you. See? Now some coal here would be good, and I will take it. I will take the free black heart as well, and we might as well. We've got lots of bombs. Let's go ahead and see if we can get some more free shit out of it. No, we do not, but that's okay. Okay, I'm okay with that level. It wasn't terrible. Let's bomb on down. I don't know if we dinked around too much for boss rush. We might be okay. We'll have to see how it comes out. Power pill. More bombs. Good enough for me. We do have at least one key, so we... What the fuck hit me there? Oh, anyways. Yeah, hell with it. Let's just do it. We have been undefined. Yay! Super magnet, new. Nothing there. Bunch of jerks here. Well, at least we're lucky. And we get our key, that's good. And I get stuck on the corner, that was bad. Puberty pill does no good to me. Let's go ahead and take pay to play. We seem to be having an issue with keys anyways. Okay, we can run a little endless nameless game here. Let's grab the key and we'll go do that. Not endless nameless, but undefined. We'll see if we can clear a couple rooms. We'll pop it. And then we'll go back and grab the battery and see where we get with it. Bubba's head we'll pick up for the transformation purposes and call it good. We'll run back this way. Maybe we won't. I don't know. Okay, so let's pop it. Let's see where we end up. We get two keys, okay. Free secret rooms are never a bad thing. Let's go again. We're gonna go there now, okay, fine. Well, the rest of this we just aren't going to worry about. We're going to go right down for the boss, I guess. So let us proceed south in a leisurely fashion. We'll try this way. This is not the boss room by any means. And that was what you would call dumb damage, folks. I mean with a capital D. Oh my god, I am terrible at this game, I should never play it again, but we've already decided that and I'm still playing it, so I guess that's a moot point at this point. We'll just power pill him for a sec here. Nam 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 nam. Nam 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 nam. Nam 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 nam. And Endless Nameless has decided that I need more power pills. Alright, we grab an auto turret, buddy. And down we go. Without even using a single power pill. Okay. We are a little short on time. We're not going to go through the arcade because of that. Let's see what we can do here. Oh, it's a Pindle room. Okay. Bite me, Pindle. Or I shall bite you, apparently, is the actual answer there. Okay, our item room was a quick find. Pinking shears, oh yes, we will take the pink. As you know what they say, always gotta have one in the pink, one in the stink, you know. We're gonna get a free shit card apparently. We are pay to play, so I really don't want to throw too much money in that. Let's check the shop real fast here. Anything I really want in here? I'm going to go with no. They're apparently cursed, and I did not realize it, so that's good to know. Yeah, we'll go back there for a second here as soon as I get this done with. I should have went ahead and bombed those. Pretty high chance of getting at least one soul heart out of there, and I've got plenty of bombs, so why not? Apparently that room was here, okay. And we'll get one out of it, that's okay with me. I'm okay with this. Let's get out of here and go kill ourselves a boss. We'll pink. Go eat mom, thank you. We'll take some dumb damage on mom because we can. But in the end, I think we'll be okay here. Let's go for the Polaroid again. And we'll have the fun of rubber cement, apparently, is going to be our poison of choice this time around. We're going to have another boss with too much friggin' health or two. because why not? We need to have bosses with way too much goddamn health. We're just gonna sit here and wait for Mr. Cage to stop spinning around and we'll shoot him from here. Oh, he went away over there. Okay, fine. Death's touch with rubber cement is interesting. It sometimes bounces through them, sometimes it just bounces off of them. It's kind of a weird randomness to it, but it makes it so if you put them inside a wall or something, or next to a wall, you can do brutal things to them like that. It just destroys things that get next to a wall when you have it. Alright, we're gonna get double guardy. That's already dead. And that goes for the pindle. Let's go ahead and get a pinking cheer up. Thank God we have something penetrative so we don't have to worry about the Mask of Infamy there. Ow, you goddamn asshole. Gotta hate those guys doing that. Anything that pops up directly underneath me just annoys the shit out of me. I can't deny it. It just does. Let's pink again. And there's a gate over here, so we're just gonna stand over here and watch him shoot shit. Good, he didn't do this rando brimstone lasers, which is fine by me. I believe this is Gabriel, so we'll take care of Gabriel and Loki. Interesting things you can do with tractor beam in a big room, though. So you can be like, yeah, I want all those right there, right now. And it'll take all the ones you have stacked up all the way across the room and put them right above you right now. Because when you turn it, it turns all your shots with you. So you can kind of use that to your advantage. Now, when I say you, I mean you, not me, because I will not be able to. I will gloriously fuck it up every time, and it will be bad. But, you know, if you're a better player than me, you can use it to your advantage at least. Okay, well, the triple Larry is not going to be a threat. We know this. I'm going to try and not get shot by this guy. I don't know how well that's going to turn out, but we're going to give it a shot. Nope. We got over here war? Yeah, war. Okay. I mean, throw another pink down. We'd have like four of them, so that's pretty good. God damn it. Fucking adversary. Get out of here. Oh, there's Raghead, or Ragman, I mean. I don't know why I always call him a Raghead. I guess he just looks like he should have a Raghead. I don't know. Do I feel like wearing on my finger with chocolate milk? Probably not. I'm just gonna skip it. So that was a whole big old waste of time. We got the rubber cement, I guess, so it wasn't a total waste, but wasn't really all that worth. And well, let's see how we do in utero. This little guy. Why the fuck did I think I'd hit that already? Thank you. Once again, taking stupid damage. Please ship me out something useful. Half a heart is not useful. Thank you. Life up, I'll take. Temperance, if I had some kind of a life upgrade-y thingy, or... Sorry, if I had some kind of a shield, I would do it, but... I don't, and so therefore, I have no use for it, so let's go ahead and continue on with this glorious run we're in. Hopefully I won't completely botch it and die. That'd be a good option. I'm gonna call that worth it. Since we can get the battery and get it right back, so that's glorious. Notice while those guys may be afraid of you, they have no problem shooting blood lasers at you still. So just because they're afraid does not mean they're not dangerous. Who knows, maybe they just got a new Discovery Series playland and, you know, they're going to be naked and afraid. With blood lasers. I swear to God it'll get better ratings. I mean, speaking of weird ass shit people watch, who watches that shit? Is what I'd like to know. I mean, honestly, who watches that shit and then can look at themselves in the mirror and go, okay, I am normal. I just don't ever see it. If you're, you know, sitting there watching Naked Afraid, nah, I don't think so. Pretty sure people that just can't afford internet watch that because they think they might get to see a boob. That's my thought on it, but we'll just leave my thoughts out of it, because why not? Alright, well, I got a conquest, so we're going to get a horsey. Which is unfortunate, but oh well. We do get a deal with the devil, though, so let's see what we can pick up here. Okay, I will take that. We can take a Gimpy and then pick up a couple hearts. That's fine. Okay, I think I'm going to stick with the Pinking Shears. Probably a better option at this point. It's such an awesome item. I mean, the damage it does is the biggest thing about it. It's just brutal damage. Especially if you can get it to stack multiple on the screen at once. Then it just gets really bad. This is not my idea of a good room. Well, it was a fairly dangerous room, I might say. Sure, why not? We'll double key it. We'll give it a double key. Double key. And we'll continue on through here. Let's grab that one real quick since the guys are not there. This next one's kind of a pain because you got to do the loop-de-loop up and out. One of them rooms is not very fun without flight. Let's go ahead and switch out Endless Nameless for that. I believe Black Feather will give us a bit more touch of a chance to get Black Hearts, if I remember right. Hangman? Sure, we can do that. I'll take a Hangman. There's probably going to be an instance where I would like flight in a room and I don't want to use my Pinking Shears, so we'll give it there. We'll run on that premise that that's probably going to happen. And the red poop popped right underneath me as usual, as a jerk as it will do. Double stone chest is just one of them things I cannot refuse. We'll go ahead and use Pinking Shear, even though it shouldn't be too hard of a fight here. It was kind of a crappy double stone chest, but it was a double stone chest. You kind of got to take it and just, you know, say, oh well, when it's not good. Now that is about the most well-protected beggar I've ever seen. That boy is in there like, he's like, I got this, guys. I am in the Flynn, like Flynn. Nobody's ever getting to me. Sure, why not? Do I want to take a Bible? Why not? Sure. It's an instant kill. I mean, it'll guarantee that I don't take damage on the friggin' heart fight. Which I do surprisingly often, and I also take damage doing things like that. That we're not bothering with. This should be entertaining, though. Shoop da whoop! Really? I am just so done with that. Red poop. Red poop has been my bane, apparently, here. Alright, what do we got here? We got a two hearts, not gonna do anything. We've got a Wheel of Fortune that we'll play just for the hell of it. Maybe we can get a something useful out of it. Looks like the answer to that might be no.
Bombs are key.
I mean, I'm not gonna have any other use for my money, so might as well just do this. See? There we go. Balls of steel out of it. Totally worth. I will say that that was worth. And we're gonna blow it up and get another penny. So we come out with one penny. Let's pop that and do that. That was fun. Hush with four hearts and... You know what? Hell with it. Let's do it. I'm sure it's gonna go badly, just because it will. Probably should have went and got my pinky shears back, but oh well. We have plenty of keys to open all these, so... We do have Curse of the Blind, which is not the best thing. Cricket's Head isn't a great thing, though. Fate's Reward isn't the worst, either. I guess if I was gonna go for Hush, I probably should have done that, and shouldn't have played that slot machine so much and kept a few points, but... Humbling Bundle. Okay. Oh, yeah, that's right. I have pay to play. We need to bomb you again. Here, let's bomb that guy. Give me stuff. Thank you. Yeah, well, hell with it. We'll bomb her again. Mostly because I would like to take that with me. Eeny, meeny, miny, and it's a juicy sack. Meh. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo, and it's a Pisces. Okay. We have plenty of bombs to do this. If you didn't know, there's an extremely high chance of that right there in those two rooms. Don't ask me why. I don't know. It's just there. A flat penny, huh? Okay. Well, let's see how it goes versus Hush. I don't know if there's any room to take flight, but we're going to take it there anyways, just for the hell of it. We're going to stand out of range here and just kind of poke away at him. I mean, we're not completely out of range, as we just proved there. We can still take damage, but... The annoying thing about the Hush fight is he does have damage reduction based on your damage. So no matter how much you shoot him... Or how much damage you have, it will still take a while to do this fight. It's just hard-coded that way, basically. There's a couple of things that can make it go faster. Guppy transformation is usually one, because you get more damage sources, which it does not take into account when it calculates its damage reduction. It just takes your raw damage into account, so more shots with more damage is better. And flies are obviously more shots, but, you know, as long as you're fairly careful, it's not too bad. I will probably not make this fight because taking less than four hits in this fight is not something I will probably do too often. But we'll see how it goes. Sadly, I do not have more than one red heart, so those are completely useless. But still fun. Let's just mob all them flies out of here. Maybe we'll get lucky and a fly will drop us something decent. We do have Gimpy, so if we take a hit, you know, we may actually get a soul heart or a soul heart to drop for us, but, you know, we'll see. Looks like I picked a good spot, so we're just going to chill here. Nice thing about that rubber cement is we've got a lot of good, got quite a good bounce effect for when he spawns things and they're just going to kind of disappear on us, so that's good. Alright, we seem to have picked the money spot so far for that. This one could get a little hairy sometimes right here. I think I'm just going to go with the option of don't fucking move and hope it works out. Because that seems to be working pretty well at this point. We're just going to go with it. We're going to roll with it. Until he starts shooting, you know, laser beam tears out of his butt. Which should start here pretty quick. Yep, there it is. Nicely, we did take our flight. So yes, there is a reason for flight. Okay. I forgot those actually left a trail of stuff on the ground that, you know, would shoot at you. So there apparently is a reason for flight in this that I've forgotten about. That's good to know. Like I said, tractor beam has that lovely effect that we can hit him from all the way over here if we happen to need to run over here to get away from him. Oh, you jerk. Running into him is not optimal, though. We'll give it that as the, we'll just say that. It's not optimal. And apparently, we actually won. So, what do you know? Amazingly, we won. So, there's that. Hush be down. We picked up an Eternal Heart. Could be worse. We did get the Humbling Bundle. Cricket's Head. So we have a good damage of 14 now. So I'm okay with that. We do not have our pinking shears anymore. But we do have Bibles. So we can still get flight when we need to. Let's go and rack them down like that. And we'll give the Montrose a little bit of a beat down. Chubb's going to take the same route. We'll see what our pills here are when everybody finishes their death animations here. Health down, that's no good. Double power pill and a derp, okay. Well, we'll take a power pill with us. And as usual, unless I've completely stupidly overpowered, I cannot go through a gritty room without taking damage. So, at this point, I am apparently not overpowered enough to not take damage from that fight. So that's a thing. We're going to get a couple free keys for no reason. Because flat penny is a flat penny. Where were you last run when I had all them chests everywhere I couldn't open? I mean, that room was already broken as shit, but you know... There's nothing that says you can't always have a more broken run than you currently have. There's always that option. Now, I could pop flight and go in there with only one heart of damage. I don't think that's going to be worth it. I'm not going to do it. We're just going to let this all die. We'll go get the bombs. We'll see what's in here. What do we have here? We have... A Book of Revelations, which I'll gladly use, and I'll grab the battery, and I'll gladly use it again. And then we'll grab the Book of Shadows. We'll definitely take the Book of Shadows with us. I'll go with that over the Bible, especially when I'm this far down any day of the week and twice on Sundays. Okay, we'll grab that Book of Shadows back. We might as well bomb our way in there. Which way do we want to bomb our way in? Let's try down here. I mean, it's not like we don't have the bombs. I don't see any soul rocks there, so. And, okay. Well, at least we just lost all that health we got, because. Because of reasons, okay? Well, at least the stores are open. Alright, so we got 8 keys for the chest. Should we try and see if we can get one or two more maybe? Let's go look. I'm sure this will be just fine to do. I will not take any damage whatsoever doing this, I'm sure. Did we bomb this direction? I don't think so. Let's give it a shot. Callus. I will take the callus over the... Well, we'll keep the flat penny until we see if we get any more coins. And then I will take the callus. Mostly to avoid blood effects. Alright, we're going to need a couple more keys, and I guess that was actually worth. So we'll take the callus, and we'll go on down and beat up Isaac, I guess. Whew. who thankfully does not have damage reduction, so. Yeah, get out of the way. And I was going to use that Book of Shadows, but apparently it is not necessary, so we won't do it. And on down to the chest we go, or into the chest we go, I should say. To be a bit more precise, we get an Eternal Heart, and we get to see what our loot is here. What is our loot? Is a bunch of poop. Now, Jesus Shadow, okay. Kane's the other eye, poop. And I think I'll just keep the book over that. There's no real reason not to. He's gonna get fucking murdered up there. No questions asked. Let's go ahead and just use it, just in case, you know. You never know, you might need it. Alright, we're gonna get Daddy Long Legs and some lard. So we do have a little bit more hit points. It's a little bit slower, but I can deal with that. Our speed wasn't like abysmal by any means to begin with, so I'm okay with it. This is not one of them fights. I think I'm just gonna use the book here and we're gonna try and just grease him. Another one of my least favorite bosses. I just am not a fan of that boss at all. This room's just gonna be more of a stay the fuck over here and don't go over there where all the things are being blown up. Double key. Bomb buddy. Alright. And, you know, this run I probably could have done a better job of looking for secret rooms and stuff, but it is what it is at this point. It doesn't matter. It worked out okay in the end. You guys gotta wonder too, why is Greed such a cocksmoker? I mean, really. He's just a fucking absolute jerk no matter what. First he fires things at you. He spawns little heads that jump at you. He steals all your money. It's just, he's just a terrible, terrible person. Oh, I'm sure this is going to be good. Another one of them upgrades that I love and hate at the same time. Mostly because I tend to blow my own self up with it by being too close to things when they blow, when they explode when I shoot them. But we'll take it this time and we'll see how it all turns out. See, there was one right there. Boom. Boom goes me. Alright, we'll bebop on along this way. Oh, yep, these guys are dust. Triple Widow. Which I think took longer in its death animation than it did to kill it. Alright, let's just bop a stars card. I'm sure it'll take us closer to back to where we wanted to go than we were, so it's fine. And we'll go take out Mr. Blue Baby, and away we go. And this will make another run that was successful at this point. And there we are. One more Isaac run down. So, with that, I tell you thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.